So I will be working out the last problem, that is 15th problem. So just look into the income statement given in this problem. So we are not going to consider any item except this interest expenses. This interest expenses of 4000 should be shown under financing activity and also under the head operating expenses. So again you have income tax. This income tax is the provision for income tax made during the year to be paid in the next year. You just note down this amount of 17,000, which we are going to show the same amount in provision for taxation account. The additional information given is dividend declared during the year is rupees 6,000. Note down, students, this is not dividend paid, it is declared, that is by profit and loss account it is 6,000. Then equipment worth rupees 16,000 was acquired by the issue of long term loans, that is 10,000, and by paying cash rupees 6,000. So they have given an account for 16,000. So 10,000 loan has been raised for 16,000 loan, and remaining 6,000 has been paid in the form of cash. This is shown here. So long term debt. So under this amount of 75,000 and 42,000, this difference amount includes 16,000. And land was acquired for rupees 3,000. So there was no accruals and prepaid accounts for interest. So according to this adjustment, we have to prepare equipment account. So the first account to be prepared is equipment account. And then we have to prepare long-term debt account, then income tax payable account and dividend payable account. So I have shown here. So first account is equipment account. So in this, we have the opening balance and closing balance. So as I told you while discussing the adjustment, so cash paid for purchasing equipment is 6,000 and the loan raised is rupees 10,000. So then you have long term debt. So write the opening balance and closing balance. So buy equipment, that is rupees 10,000. This I have shown here. So equipment account debtor to long term loans. So long term debts account, we have to show buy equipment account 10,000. Balance account, the balancing figure that you get will be 23,000. This is nothing but the long term debts raised, which is shown under financing activity. Now we'll move on to income tax payable account. So write the opening balance and closing balance. So the income tax payable, so this is the amount of 17,000 that is provided during the year. This 17,000 of income tax should be shown as by profit and loss account 17,000. Balance account, the balance figure that we'll get will be the tax paid during the year 19,000. Now dividend payable account, write the opening and closing balance. As per the adjustment given here, dividend declared during the year is rupees 6,000. This amount should be written as by profit and loss account 6,000, and the balancing figure will be transferred to bank account, which is nothing but dividend paid. So now we'll post all the transactions recorded in the ledger accounts. First equipment account. So we have two cash accounts, 6,000. So this is nothing but purchase of equipment, will be shown under investing activity as purchase of equipment within brackets. Now purchase of equipment by issuing long term loans, you need not have to show it anywhere because it is a non-cash item. Now we'll move on to long term debts. So long term debts, we have balancing figure of rupees 23,000. This is nothing but bank account debt to long term debt, which is nothing but long term debts raised. This 23,000 should be shown under financing activity, that is increase in long term debt 23,000. Then come to income tax payable. Tax paid is rupees 19,000. This 19,000 actually we are supposed to pay as tax paid 19,000 here. So this is shown here. So income tax payable, under that we have provision for taxation made during the year to be paid in the next year. That is, this amount is rupees 17,000. So provision for taxation is 17,000. Now come to dividend payable account. So according to the adjustment, so the dividend declared during the year is 6,000. So write by profit and loss account 6,000. So this amount will be shown under operating expenses as 6,000 dividend paid, that is proposed dividend made. And the dividend paid rupees 4,000 will be shown under financing activity as dividend paid. Working out this problem, you just note down the years given. So first we have current year and then the previous year. So cash should be shown in the hand. So debtors, it is a current asset. So there has been increase in debtors. So from 79,000 to 95,000. So there is increase in current asset. So increase in current asset, you have debtors and you have stock and prepaid expenses. All these three items I have added here. You just go through this. Then you have provision for doubtful debts. So this item, I have a note on this. It should be treated as current liability. So previous year 2000, current year 3000. So there has been increase in current liability. So increase in current liability, provision for doubtful debts I have shown here as rupees 1000. So debtors and stock and prepaid expenses I have already shown you. So land account, so previous year it is 66,000, current year 69,000. So there is increase in land by rupees 3,000, which will be shown under investing activity, purchase of land rupees 3,000. So machinery and equipment account, we have already prepared the ledger account, and then provision for depreciation account. So you can transfer this amount directly. So opening balance 1,02,000, closing balance 1,13,000. The difference amount is shown as depreciation here 11,000. Move on to liability side of balance sheet. You have creditors. Previous year 78,000, current year 66,000. There has been decrease in current liability. So decrease in current liability, it should be deducted here. See 12,000. Then dividend payable account is over. Income tax payable account is also over. Long term debt also is over. Equity share capital, opening and closing balance both remains the same. So we need not have to account for this. Then you have profit and loss account balance. This amount of difference should be shown here as net profit. I have shown here as 12,000. So now we'll move on to this income statement. As I told you earlier, that is the interest expenses paid rupees 4,000. Only this item should be considered. Okay, this item will appear under the head non-operating expenses, interest expenses 4,000, and also under financing activity like interest paid rupees 4,000. Now we'll move on to the adjustment. First adjustment is over, second is also over, third is also over, and last one not to be considered. So now we will complete this cash flow statement. So we have net cash outflow from operating activity 8,000 and net cash outflow from investing activity 9,000 and net cash inflow from financing activity 15,000. So the net decrease in cash is 2,000. To this we have to add opening balance of cash as it is given in the balance sheet 13,000, and the balancing figure that you get will be closing balance of cash 11,000, which is given in the balance sheet as 11,000. With this, we'll complete the problem.